In this video, you will be learning how to set up Unity Ads so that you can monetize your game. Unity has an ads integration guide which they have done themselves, so it's actually quite simple to implement and there won't be much coding to do. I will be covering rewarded ads and interstitial ads in this video. The differences between these two is that rewarded ads reward players with incentives like game lives, coins, or energy, but interstitial ads doesn't. Alright, let's get started. The first thing we need to do is to configure our game project. Let's head over to the File tab at the top left of Unity, and we want to click on Build Settings. Make sure you set the platform to either iOS or Android, as Unity Ads only work on these two platforms. Once you're done, close the Build Settings window. Now we need to create a project ID for our game project. Head over to the Window tab at the top of Unity, and move your cursor down to General, and click on Services. Now in the Services window, you can see that Unity Ads is currently turned off right now, so let's click on it, and a new window will pop up prompting you to create a project ID. If you have already created a project ID, you can click here to link this project to your existing project ID. I don't have a project ID yet, so I'm going to create a new one. So let's select an organization and click on Create Project ID. Now they will ask you, will your app be primarily targeted to children under age 13? I will choose no for this tutorial, but if your game is targeted towards children, choose the yes option. Once you have selected your option, click on the save button just right below. As you can see, Unity Ads is still turned off, so let's click on the off icon once to turn on Unity Ads. Once it finishes loading, you should see the icon changing from off to on. You will also be given two game IDs, one for Android and one for iOS. Next, we need to install the ads package into our game project. So under the ads package section, click on Install Latest Version. Once you are done installing, go ahead and close this window. Next, we will be doing some coding to initialize Unity Ads. Let's create a new C# script and we will name it Ads Initializer. Please make sure your script is named exactly like mine to avoid any errors later on. Let's open up the Ads Initializer script. I've mentioned earlier that Unity has an ads integration guide which they have done themselves. I will leave the links in the description below. So let's open up the Initializing Ads guide. Now let's copy every line of code over here and paste it in our Ads Initializer script. So the purpose of this script is to initialize Unity Ads. Previously, we were just installing the Unity Ads package into our game project, and over here in this script, we are initializing it. The first two string type variable that we have in our script is named Android Game ID and iOS Game ID. These two variables are for us to store the Android and iOS Game ID that has been assigned to us when we first turn on Unity Ads. So in the initialize ads function, it will first check if the player is on an Android or iOS platform, followed by an ads initialization. Once the initialization is completed, the onInitializationComplete function will be called, and we will be prompted with the line Unity Ads Initialization Complete. Else, if it fails to initialize, the onInitializationFailed function will be called, and we will be prompted with the line Unity Ads Initialization Failed. Let's save the script and head back to Unity. Now we need to create a new empty game object and we will name it Ads Manager. We will attach the initialize ads script to the Ads Manager game object. You will notice that the Android and iOS game ID fail is empty, so we need to assign them with the ID that has been given to us previously. Head over to the Services tab and click on Ads. You can find both game ID at the bottom. Let's head back to the Inspector tab and assign our IDs. Please make sure you assign the game IDs correctly, the Android ID to the Android field and the iOS ID to the iOS field. Once you're done, you can close the project settings window and let's enter play mode to try it out. Alright, you can see that in the console panel, it prompted us Unity Ads Initialization Complete, which means we have successfully initialized our Unity Ads. Now we need to add a button to our game so that when we click on it, it will show an ad to us. Let's exit play mode and we will start with the rewarded ad button first. If you are just interested in implementing interstitial ads, go ahead and skip over to the interstitial ads chapter. Let's right-click on our hierarchy tab, head over to UI, and we want to create a new button. Let's name it Rewarded Ads Button. Go ahead and resize the button or change the sprite of the button to your liking. Once you're done, we need to create a new C# script called Rewarded Ads Button. Please make sure your script is named exactly like mine to avoid any errors later on. Let's open up the script. Now let's open up the link for Rewarded Ads Integration Guide. Link can be found in the description below. Let's copy every line of code here and paste it in our Rewarded Ads Button script. So the purpose of this script is to firstly load an ad, secondly show the ad, and lastly reward the player with an incentive once they have finished watching the entire ad. The first variable we have over here is a button type variable. This is for us to assign the rewarded ads button we created back in Unity so that we can show an ad when we click on it. The next two string type variable has been assigned to an ad unit ID called rewarded_android and rewarded_ios. So you might be wondering, how did we get these two unit ID? Now let's head over to unity.com and I will show you how we get these two unit ID. Firstly, sign in to your Unity account and click on this nine square icon. And we want to head over to the dashboard. Over here, make sure you have selected the project you are currently working on and head over to monetization on the bottom left panel. Once you are here, head over to add units and we want to click on this complete activation button. Now we want to select the first option, I'm not using mediation, only Unity Ads, and click on OK. Once you're done, there should be 6 ad units appearing. Now take a look at the 3rd and 4th ad unit. You should see their ID name as rewarded_android and rewarded_ios. So this is how we got our ad unit ID back in our script. This step is extremely important, so do remember to head over to this page to complete the Unity Ads activation. Do not change any of the ad unit ID as we need it to be named exactly the same as the one back in our script. Alright, let's head back to our rewarded ads button script. Head down to the on Unity Ads show complete function, and this is where we want to reward our players once they have finished the ad. You can see a comment here written, grant a reward. Since this is just a tutorial, I don't have any in-game incentive to give out. So I'm going to just debug.log, you have gained 10 coins. Now let's head up to the load ad function and you can see a comment written, important, only load content after initialization. So we need to call this load ad function once we have finished initializing Unity Ads. So if you remember correctly, we initialize our Unity Ads over at the Ads Initializer script. So let's save this script and head over to the Ads Initializer script. Firstly, to call a function from another script, we need a reference to that script. So below our game ID variable, we will create a reference to the other script. Let's name it as Rewarded Ads Button with a small letter R. Head down to the onInitializationComplete function, and we will simply call the loadAd function from the Rewarded Ads Button script. So that's all the coding we need to do. Save the script and let's head back to Unity. Now with the Rewarded Ads Button object selected, we want to attach the Rewarded Ads Button script to it. The showAdButton variable hasn't been assigned yet, so let's click on the button component right above and simply drag and drop it into the field. Head over to the Ads Manager object and we want to assign the Rewarded Ads Button script, so let's drag the Rewarded Ads Button object and drop it into the field. Alright, let's enter play mode to try it out. You can see in the console, it prompted us that initialization is complete. It's loading ad and then ad is loaded. Now let's click on the button. Alright, if you see this screen being displayed, it means you have done all the steps correctly. Let's click on the close button and check our console window. Perfect, you can see that it prompted us rewarded ad completed and also you have gained 10 coins. Perfect, we have finished implementing our rewarded ads. Next up, we will be implementing our interstitial ads. You can stop here if you are just planning on having rewarded ads. Alright, let's create an interstitial ad button. Right click on the hierarchy tab, head over to UI, and we want to create a new button. Let's name it Interstitial Ads Button. Go ahead and resize the button or change the sprite of the button to your liking. Once you're done, we need to create a new C# script called Interstitial Ads Button. Please make sure your script is named exactly like mine to avoid any errors later on. Let's open up the script. Now let's open up the link for Interstitial Ads Integration Guide. Link can be found in the description below. Let's copy every line of code here and paste it in our Interstitial Ads Button script. So the purpose of this script is to firstly load an ad, secondly show the ad. Firstly, we want to change the public class name to Interstitial Ads Button. Exactly the same name as this script. The first two string type variable in this script has been assigned to an ad unit ID called interstitial_android and interstitial_ios. So you might be wondering, how did we get these two ad unit ID? Now let's head over to unity.com and I will show you how we get these two unit ID. Firstly, sign in to your Unity account and click on this nice square icon. And we want to head over to dashboard. Over here, make sure you have selected the project you are currently working on and head over to monetization on the bottom left panel. Once you're here, we want to click on this complete activation button. Now we want to select the first option. I'm not using mediation, only Unity Ads. And click on OK. Once you're done, there should be 6 ad unit appearing. Now take a look at the first and second ad unit. You should see their ID name as interstitial_android and interstitial_ios. So this is how we get our unit ID back in our script. This step is extremely important, so do remember to head over to this page to complete the Unity Ads activation. Do not change any of the ad unit ID as we need it to be named exactly the same as the one back in our script. Alright, let's head back to our Interstitial Ads Button script. Now let's take a look at the loadAd function. You can see a comment written, important, only load content after initialization. So we need to call this loadAd function once we have finished initializing Unity Ads. So if you remembered correctly, we initialize our Unity Ads over at the Ads Initializer script. So let's save this script and head over to the Ads Initializer script. Firstly, to call a function from another script, we need a reference to that script. So below our game ID variable, we will create a reference to the other script. We will just name it Interstitial Ads Button with a small letter I. Now let's head down to the onInitializationComplete function and we will simply call the loadAd function from the Interstitial Ads Button script. So that's all the coding we need to do. Save the script and let's head back to Unity. Now with the Interstitial Ads Button object selected, we want to attach the Interstitial Ads Button script to it. Now we need to call the showAd function when we click on the button. Head over to the Ads Manager object and we want to assign the Interstitial Ads Button script. So let's drag the Interstitial Ads Button object and drop it into the field. Alright, let's enter play mode to try it out. Alright, if you see this screen displayed on your screen, it means you have done all the steps correctly. You should see a skip button at the top left of the screen and a close button at the top right of the screen. So that's all for this Unity tutorial and I hope you have learned something from it. Don't forget to click on the like and subscribe button if you enjoyed this video. See you guys in the next one. Peace.